was actually shocked at how well this worked and how much I like it. Welcome back to Our Family Bee. I'm Brigitte, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can make your own homemade dishwasher detergent and homemade laundry detergent. I've been testing these out for about a week or so, a couple different recipes, so I'm going to share with you what works, what doesn't work, and what I plan to do in the future. So let's get into it. For these two recipes, you just need a couple simple ingredients. Super washing soda, borax, salt, a bar of soap, citric acid, and optional essential oil. I chose lavender and lemon. Oh, and two jars or some container to store them in. I would recommend glass just so that nothing leaches into the plastic. And one more thing, a grater of some sort. Okay, let's start with what I made first. This was kind of all an experiment, but I am liking the results. So the first thing I did was laundry detergent. I'm trying to kind of minimize what we're using in the house and the ingredients, trying to make homemade things that I can like whip up from ingredients I already have in the house. And that way I don't have to, if I run out, go buy something specific for that purpose. Same with cleaners for the mirror and surface cleaners and stuff to clean the house with toilet wise and tub wise and all of that. So I'm trying to use a lot of the same ingredients throughout the whole house and just mixing and matching varying options of them depending on what I'm cleaning. So, oh, I got a delivery note from Benjamin. Let's see here. Thanks, Benjamin. Love you. Okay, first thing I tried was a laundry detergent. So all I did was mix 1 cup of the super washing soda, 1 cup of borax, and I grated half of a bar of soap. I decided just to use like a regular, this is probably about this big, bar of body wash soap.
That's more of the same thing.
It's different.
Okay. Oh, feels good. Feel it.
Mm-hmm.
Feel it.
Make sure you wash your hand after. I have since made a new recipe with the Phil's Naphtha bar soap, and I do like that a lot better. So I will use this, but I feel like since it's just a body wash bar, it wasn't like as cleaning, like super cleaning. It wasn't as good at cleaning. What am I trying to say? And actually, I do want to add some OxiClean to this, which I don't have yet, but I'll probably add a half of a cup. So that's one cup, half a cup, and then I did half a bar of soap. You could add more soap. I might grate some extra of the Phil's Naphtha and put it in here to use it just to give it a little extra cleaning power. I do pretty large loads in our washing machine, so I did 2 tablespoons of this. I think a lot of recipes call for 1. I felt like the loads were pretty overfilled, so I end up using 2 just to make sure. And they clean very well. I think when I went to the second recipe, it cleaned a lot better. So I would definitely recommend this recipe over that one. So this recipe is basically the same thing. It's 1 cup of super washing soda, 1 cup of borax, and I did half of a Phil's Naphtha bar, which is a bigger bar in general. I just got these from Walmart. Actually, probably it was like a third. I would maybe even do a half. Depends on how much, I guess, of the soap you want in it. And I'm going to be adding another half of a cup of OxiClean just to give it some extra stain fighting power. You know, the kids get all of their clothes super messy, especially when they go outside and all of that, plus food. I mean, if you have kids, you know, comment down below. I know what you mean. So this, I'm going to add the OxiClean to it when I get it. I haven't gotten it from the store because life is crazy, of course. And yes, you can have this. And so this is the one I've been using the last several days, and I do laundry almost every day, it seems. And I do like this a lot better. And for the laundry detergent, I just literally took this grater and grated this bar of soap. It does take a little bit of time, not a ton. And the Phil's Naphtha actually grates to be really small. You can't even really tell. I mean, you can just see that it's yellow in here. The other bar of soap you can see makes these little curls in it. So I would just, if you're gonna do it, go with the Phil's naphtha. At the time I did the first recipe, I didn't have the Phil's naphtha, so just do the Phil's naphtha. But let's talk about smells, because I am all about the smells. And what I've been doing, I've been adding lavender to the rinse cycle little thing in the middle. We have a spin washer thing, and I add vinegar to it. So vinegar, I pour a little bit, maybe quarter to half a cup in the actual washing load drum, and then I add a little bit into the center console thing where the rinse cycle stuff should go, and then I add some lavender. I also will sprinkle the lavender onto the dryer balls, which I have in the dryer. So between those two, it smells a little bit more fresh. Now, I did try it with orange essential oil and like the bergamot, however you say it. And it just wasn't, it didn't last. I think it was too mild of a scent. But with the lavender, and I have also tried lemongrass, it is actually, it's actually something you can smell. Hold please. Okay, so with the lavender and the lemongrass, I do feel like the smell stays longer into the clothes, especially when the heat of the dryer can sometimes dissipate, you know, more delicate smells. So I do feel like lavender or lemongrass is the way to go if you're gonna use essential oils to scent your laundry. Thus far, I have been really loving it. I will make it again. I definitely am interested to see how the OxiClean helps. A lot of the recipes have OxiClean. It's just that I didn't have any and it is an optional one, but I do think it will add a little bit more whitening to the whites and it will help with stain removing for the kids. But if I have a heavily stained area, like pizza sauce, because children, you know, I just take this and I wet the clothes a little bit as the water is pouring into our washer, and I will just rub it with this until it's like really rubbed out and like soapy. And that actually does really help to take the stains out, and I don't have to spray some extra stuff on it. Although I do have an OxiClean spray, but this is supposed to be really good for stain removing. So, and this is super cheap. I got it for $1 from Walmart. And so this was like $4 to $5. It was under $5, and this was under $5 too. So when you're talking about how much you're making, I'd have to do a cost breakdown, but it's really not expensive at all, and you can make it yourself, which is always fun. I do like to make a lot of homemade things. Before we move on to the next recipe, if you haven't already subscribed, make sure you hit the button down below, because we post videos every Tuesday and Friday and you don't want to miss it. So make sure you hit the bell and click it up to all. And if you don't follow us on Instagram, what are you waiting for? Head on over to OFB Social, because we post over there. We're trying to post more, honestly. Oh my gosh, it is just difficult some days, but our goal is to connect with you. So if you message us on Instagram or you comment on something, we will message you back. We, at this point, at the time of recording, respond to every single comment on YouTube and on Instagram. It's a priority for us because we want to connect with you guys. We are here because of community, and you are our community. So make sure you're subscribed. And if you haven't already checked out our website at ourfamilyb.com, we have lots of resources over there, and we have our homemade DIY lip balm kits. We were selling these right before Christmas. If you haven't checked it out, I'll link it down below. If you like making stuff yourself, but you don't wanna buy all of these bulk ingredients, especially for the lip balm, because those come in huge quantities, and if you're only making, you know, 10 at a time, it can be like, I'm not gonna go through this for like 5 years. You can buy a kit, do it yourself still at home, and have lots of fun. It's much cheaper, it's all natural, it's mostly organic, and it's very customizable as far as what essential oils you want to add. Peppermint, lemon, lavender, a holiday blend, so many choices. So check that out at ourfamilyb.com. Okay, for the next recipe, we are doing a dishwasher detergent. I need some water. Where's my water, Benjamin? I don't have water. Okay, for the next recipe, I am gonna tell you, I was actually shocked at how well this worked and how much I like it. For the dishwasher detergent recipe, which I have never made before, I have made the laundry detergent in the past, but this I've never done, and so this is the recipe I decided to use. 1 cup of the super washing soda, 1/4 cup of any type of salt. This is the salt I had. I mean, of course, kosher salt, just any salt, any cheap salt. And I used 1/2 cup of citric acid. Now, citric acid is added to a lot of things to keep it fresh. I got this huge thing on Amazon for think it was under $15, and it's gonna last a while. But apparently you can use this for tons of things that I had no idea about. On it, it says laundry, cleaning, preserving, degreasing, sprouting, canning, drying, freezing, jarring, arts and crafts, bread making, fresher foods, candy making, pH adjustment, water softening. I mean, what does this thing not do? So I wasn't that worried about getting a huge bag because I know I'll find uses for it somewhere in the house. And since I'm trying to use a lot of the same ingredients for different things in the house, you can substitute things a lot of times. So I was not worried about having this like go bad or anything. I mean, it's citric acid. It'll probably last forever. So I did half a cup of this, and the last ingredient is I added essential oil. So I chose lemon. You can obviously use anything you want. Lemon is pretty typical for cleaning, especially for in the dishwasher. Also has some degreasing power, so I mean, lemon's the way to go, and it's not that expensive, which is good because we want to try to keep our costs down. So I added all the powdered ingredients together in a bowl, mixed it up, then added 40 drops of essential oil, the lemon, and poured it into this jar, airtight jar. And if you do this recipe, it will make about 30 loads, so 1 tablespoon each, so that's about a month. I'm actually really shocked, you guys, at how well this worked. I was doubtful, let me tell you, I was doubtful. But I'm gonna overlay some B-roll here. You can see just how clean stuff came out. And I kind of pre-rinse, but not fully. Like, I still leave bits of food on there. Like, I don't take the time to really, like, wipe it clean. I just stick it in because I figure the dishwasher should do its job, and so why take the extra time? So I leave this stuff pretty caked sometimes, and it comes out so clean. I tell you, I was really shocked. So if you've never tried this, I would definitely encourage you to try it. Let me know how you like it, because honestly, I was blown away. It definitely does a better job than like store-bought detergents. I usually get store brand generic dishwasher detergent, and you know, it does a fine job, but like, this is so easy. And generally I don't like to do powder because I don't know, it can get messy if it spills or the kids try to do it, but it's been so easy to do, and it has just worked so well that like, I'm fine with the powder. I don't fill the entire spot up because I just use 1 tablespoon and that's it, and it does such a great job. So listen, have you made anything yourself at home that's a special DIY thing? Let me know in the comments down below, because I'm always looking for new ideas for cleaners and different things to try out in the house. I like doing crafty things, but I like them to be productive and useful crafty things, if that makes sense. So if you've never commented below, make sure you comment with your name and say hi, because we love getting to know you guys. Until we meet again, don't forget, life is better together. Why must you get into everything? What? Why must you get into everything?